Hello students, in this video we are going to discuss recovery of copper. So students, as we know, after the smelting process of copper extraction, copper matte is obtained. So in this video, I will tell you how to recover copper from copper matte. The molten copper matte is transferred into the Bessemer converter from the blast furnace. Bessemer converter is pear-shaped furnace made up of steel, which lined inside with lime or magnesium oxide. It possesses a small nozzle called triads, through which a blast of hot air mixed with sand is blown. So during this process, following reactions takes place. If any trace of ferrous sulfide present in the mat, it oxidizes to ferrous oxide in the next step, which combine with the silica and form sludge. In the next step, copper sulfide is oxidized to cuprous oxide, and in the fourth reaction we will see the remaining copper sulfide reacts with cuprous oxide and form copper along with the sulfur dioxide. So after the reaction has been completed, the converter is tilted and the molten copper is poured in the sand molds. So on cooling, sulfur dioxide, nitrogen and oxygen escape from the metal, and the copper thus obtained is 99% pure and is known as blister copper. Next step is the refining of the copper. So blister copper is purified by using following methods. Number one, we are going to discuss pooling. So what is pooling? The blister copper is purified by heating it strongly in a reverberatory furnace in presence of air. So the impurities are removed. So during the pooling, impurities are either removed as volatile oxides or it converted into a sludge. Some of the copper also changes to cuprous oxide. This is reduced back to copper by stirring the molten metal with green poles of wood. The hydrocarbons present in the freshly cut poles reduces cuprous oxide to copper, which is about 99.5% pure. Second method of refining is electrolytic refining. So what is electrolytic refining? Make impure copper anode and pure copper cathode dipped into an electrolytic solution of acidified copper sulfate and pass the current. So the impure copper from the anode goes into the solution, and pure copper from the solution gets deposited on the cathode, and the impurities from the anode settle down, which is called anode mud. So if you see in this reaction, at anode, copper oxidizes to form copper ion, and at cathode, copper ion reduces to copper and get deposited on the cathode. So by this way, pure copper is obtained. So students, this is all about recovery of copper. Thank you.